It is where the boys of summer first learn how to walk. And where baseball is more green grass than green backs. A place where fans still are and players still do.
Ice cold Miller Beer.
This is the Cactus League in Arizona. 12 major league teams in 9 different stadiums in 7 different cities. From the end of February to the end of March, 1.2 million people, over 60% of them visitors, will watch teams work out and play nice amongst themselves, roughly 30 games each in 30 days.
What happens is they come and they stay. The weather is warm and there's so much to do, and they don't come just for one or two games. They come for sometimes a week at a time.
Which for a city like Tucson turns into $30 million. It has 3 teams and 2 stadiums. Just a portion of the $310 million attributed to spring training statewide. Its sister Grapefruit League in Florida contributes a like amount to that state's bottom line. But that's just hot dog money.
Did it play in Peoria?
It did play in Peoria.
J.P. De La Montaña is president of the Cactus League.
There?
The real impact of spring training can be long term and counted in the billions in development.
In Peoria, for example, it was built, the stadium was built, and you could look 2 miles in any direction and not see anything but orange groves. Now there's 18 restaurants, 10 hotels, a shopping mall, ice skating rinks, bowling alleys, movie theaters, things like that.
Which explains why places you've never heard of, and in some places didn't even exist 10 years ago, are spending tens of millions on facilities to lure teams for a month a year. The Dodgers are leaving Florida for Arizona, as are the Indians. And the White Sox are rumored to be leaving Tucson for Glendale. Suddenly this.
So it's amortized, the expense is amortized over a long period of time,
yes.
Plus the revenue stream is continuous.
Yes.
Year-round as it's here.
Becomes spring training talk. I like balls and strikes better.
Swing, batter, batter, swing.